Very good morning, dear children. In my previous video, I read half story Rip Van Winkle for you. Rip Van Winkle written by Washington Irving. So let me recap the story for you. The story is set in a village which is situated at the foot of Catskill Mountains by the side of Hudson River. And it's the village of great antiquity. It's an old village, very old village, which was founded by the Dutch colonist. And once upon a time, there used to live a gentleman whose name was Rip Van Winkle. He was a wonderful human being, very kind fellow, good-natured fellow, very happy person, always willing to help other people, very kind and obedient husband. And on the contrary, on the opposite, his wife Dame Van Winkle was a very rude lady. She was short-tempered and she had a sharp tongue, and she was always angry with her husband Rip Van Winkle because there was one error in Rip Van Winkle's personality that we read. See, there the great error in Rip's composition was an aversion to all kinds of profitable labor. Means he did not like hard work at all. He didn't want to do anything which could provide him profit. He didn't want to earn anything. He had no interest in earning any livelihood for his family. He was only happy helping other people out. अगर दूसरे लोगों के लिए उसे कोई भी मेहनत वाला काम करना पड़ता तो वो बड़े शौक से करता, लेकिन जब उसे अपने लिए कोई काम करना है, जिस काम के बदले उसे थोड़ा बहुत पैसा मिले, जिस काम के बदले में उसे कुछ बेनिफिट मिले, प्रॉफिट मिले, ऐसे काम को करने से वो हमेशा बचता था. एंड दिस वॉज़ द रीज़न दैट हिज वाइफ वॉज़ वेरी अनहैप्पी विद हिम. हिज वाइफ केप्ट ऑन डाइनिंग इन हिज ईयर्स अबाउट हिज आइडलनेस, हिज केयरलेसनेस एंड द रूइन ही वॉज़ ब्रिंगिंग टू हिज फैमिली. हिज वाइफ केप्ट ऑन स्कोल्डिंग हिम ऑल द टाइम दैट यू आर अ केयरलेस मैन, यू आर अ लेजी फेलो, you are bringing the ruins to our family, you are good for nothing and all that. Is tarah se uski wife hamesha usko discourage karti thi aur hamesha use daantti thi. So to avoid the bad temperament of his wife, to avoid the scoldings of his wife and to avoid the hard work in his farm, he used to escape in the jungle. It was his habit. He used to roam around the woods, the jungles or the valley, or sometimes he used to climb up the mountain, Catskill Mountains, in search of some birds and squirrels, because he was very fond of hunting the squirrels and the birds with his fowling piece. Fowling piece means a small gun which is used to kill the birds. Hunt the birds, right? So this was his favorite pastime. He was such a nice fellow. He would stay, he would sit all day long by the side of river doing the fishing. And if he is not getting any fish, he won't be complaining about it. You would give him white bread or brown bread, he would eat it without complaints. He was fully satisfied man. He had no complaints from anybody in the world. Such kind of fellow he was. So one day he was on his way to Catskill Mountains. He was hunting the squirrels and he was so unconscious. चलते 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 उसने देखा कि वो कैट्सकिल माउंटेन के टॉप पे पहुंच गया. ही रीच द टॉप ऑफ द कैट्सकिल माउंटेन एंड व्हेन ही रीच देयर देन ही गॉट अवेयर फॉर अ मिनट एंड ही फाउंड आउट दैट इट वाज गेटिंग डार्क. इट वाज द इवनिंग टाइम एंड इट वाज गेटिंग डार्क. इट वाज हिज टाइम टू गो बैक टू हिज होम. सो ही स्टार्टेड डिसेंडिंग द माउंटेन. डिसेंडिंग द माउंटेन मीन्स वॉकिंग डाउन. तो उसने पहाड़ से नीचे उतरना अभी शुरू ही किया था that he found out that somebody was calling him from the background. Somebody was shouting his name, Rip Van Winkle, Rip Van Winkle. Even his dog, his pet dog, Wolf, who always used to give him company while he was on his way to jungle or or he's hunting any animal, his dog would always be there with him. So even his dog heard that somebody was calling his master. Even he got alert and they started looking around. Unhone charo taraf dekha, but there was nobody. Only a crow was flying up in the sky. Besides that, there was nobody. So Rip Van Winkle thought that my fancy must have deceived me, means it is the result of my imagination. Shayad mujhe galti se awaaz sunai de rahi hai. There's nobody who's calling me. So once again he started stepping down the mountain, but once again he heard somebody was calling his name, Rip Van Winkle, Rip Van Winkle, and he got alert. And this time he was surprised because it was an isolated place. The top of the mountain was a strange place, very lonely, very isolated. Wahan pe koi human beings nahi rehte the, koi ghar nahi tha. To Rip Van Winkle ne expect nahi kiya tha ki usse wahan koi awaaz laga sakta hai, usse wahan koi mil sakta hai. But he saw that a man from the opposite side, a man was coming towards him. Usne ek aadmi ko apni taraf aate hue dekha. And the appearance of this man was very strange. How was this man's appearance? The stranger was singular in appearance. He was short and old fellow with bushy hair and grizzled beard. He was a short fellow. He was old. And he had bushy hair, uske uljhe hue baal the, lambe lambe baal the, and he had grey beard, boodhe logon ki tarah daadhi thi uski. And this man was dressed in old Dutch fashion, antique Dutch fashion means old Dutch fashion, a cloth jerking strapped around his waist. Jerking means jacket. This man had tied up a jacket around his waist, and he had worn a pair of breeches. Breeches means trousers. And on his shoulders, this man had carried a keg. Keg means ek barrel ke jaisa ek bada container hota hai, jiske andar liquid alcohol rakha jata hai. Bada sa drum jisko aap keh sakte ho. This man had carried this big container on his shoulder. It appeared to Rip Van Winkle that some kind of liquid is there inside this. Some kind of drink is there inside this container. And this man was pointing at him. He made the signs for Rip to approach and assist him with the load. उस आदमी ने बोला, मुँह से कुछ नहीं बोला, सिर्फ इशारा किया Rip Van Winkle को कि तुम मेरी तरफ आओ, मेरे पास आओ और इस कंटेनर को, इस बड़े से केग को उठाने में मेरी हेल्प करो. एंड एज इट वॉज़ द नेचर ऑफ Rip Van Winkle, ही वॉज़ वेरी हेल्पफुल इन नेचर फॉर अदर पीपल, फॉर हेल्पिंग अदर पीपल. ही वॉज़ ऑलवेज रेडी. सो ही क्विकली वेंट टूवर्ड्स दिस मैन एंड दे बोथ स्टार्टेड वॉकिंग. सी वॉट हैपन आफ्टर दैट. द टू लेबर्ड ऑन इन साइलेंस अप द वाइल्ड माउंटेन, म्यूचुअली रिलीविंग वन अनदर ऑफ द लोड, till they came to the hollow surrounded by mountains. So both of these men, two means Rip Van Winkle and that old strange fellow, वो जो बूढ़ा आदमी उसे मिला था, वो दोनों, they started laboring on the silence of the wild mountain, mutually relieving one another of the load. बारी बारी से उन दोनों ने उस केग को उठाना शुरू किया. First it was Rip Van Winkle who was carrying it. After few, after taking few steps, he would give this this keg to the old man to carry. इस तरह से he started giving him company. Rip Van Winkle started giving this old fellow company while he was carrying the keg for him, because he was very helpful in nature. And finally, they came to a hollow. Hollow means an empty space. Hollow means an empty space. You can underline this word and write its meaning. So there came, आगे चलते गए वो वैली में, चलते गए पहाड़ में, चलते गए चलते गए, और आगे चलते 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 एक जगह आई which was empty. There was an empty space surrounded by the mountains. Here Rip saw some old-looking people dressed in quaint, outlandish fashion playing ninepins. All of them had beards of various shapes and colors. Rip's companion now emptied the contents of the keg into large flagons. Rip was tempted to taste the draught. When he had drunk as much as he wanted to, he fell into a deep sleep. So what happened? जब वो उस जगह पहुँचे which was an empty space surrounded by the mountains, when both of them, the old man and Rip Van Winkle, they both when reached there with the heavy keg on their shoulders, then Rip saw some other men who were looking like the old man. उसने वहाँ पे अजीब से odd looking means very strange people. Odd looking means very strange other people he had seen. They were dressed in quaint outlandish fashion. Quaint outlandish fashion means they had worn very different clothes. उनके कपड़े भी इस बूढ़े आदमी की तरह बहुत अजीब थे. These were not the clothes usually the normal people living in that village used to wear. These were very strange clothes that they had worn, and they were playing ninepins. Ninepins is a type of game. And they were playing this game. All of them had beards of various shapes and colors. सबसे अजीब बात ये थी that even the color of their beards was different, and even the shapes of their beard, उनकी दाढ़ी का रंग और उनकी दाढ़ी की shape भी बहुत अलग थी. It was not normal. Rip's companion now emptied the contents of the keg. Who is Rip's companion here? Old man. Who is Rip's companion we are talking about? This is the old man जिसे वो मिला था, जिसकी help करते करते वो इस जगह पहुँचा था. That man now emptied the contents of the keg into a large flagon. Flagon means a big container, a big bowl. एक बहुत बड़ा container, बहुत बड़ा बर्तन. तो उस आदमी ने क्या किया, he emptied the contents, he put the liquid, he put the drink which was there in that big keg, he poured it into another container. उसने उस बड़े keg container से सारा का सारा जो liquid उसके अंदर था, जो drink था उसके अंदर, उसे एक बहुत बड़े बर्तन में उड़ेल दिया. And then what happened? Rip was tempted to taste the draught. Draught means drink. And now Rip was very thirsty. Now Rip wanted to taste. Tempted to taste means he wanted to taste the draught. Draught means this drink. जब उसने उस बूढ़े आदमी को वो drink keg से बहुत बड़े कंटेनर में डालते हुए देखा तो उसका दिल ललचा गया. Now he was greedy. He wanted to taste this drink. And then when he had drunk as much as he wanted to, he fell into a deep sleep. So in that strange place, among those strange people, अब Rip Van Winkle एक अजीब जगह पे पहुंचा है और वो जितने भी लोग उसके चारों तरफ हैं उन लोगों को वो जानता नहीं है. वो सब स्ट्रेंजर्स हैं, दिखने में अजीब हैं, उनके कपड़े बहुत अजीब हैं, उनकी दाढ़ी बड़ी हुई है और बहुत अजीब सी शेप और कलर में है. लेकिन रिप को इन लोगों के बीच में अजीब नहीं लग रहा. उसने जब उस कंटेनर के अंदर जो ड्रिंक था उसे देखा, उसको लालच आ गया और उसने सोचा कि मुझे ये पीना है. ही वॉज़ वेरी टायर्ड आफ्टर रोमिंग अराउंड द जंगल ऑल डे लॉन्ग. ही वॉज़ टायर्ड एंड ही वॉज़ थर्स्टी, सो ही ड्रैंक इट एंड ही केप्ट ऑन ड्रिंकिंग इट. जब तक उसका दिल नहीं भरा उसने इस ड्रिंक को पिया, और इस ड्रिंक को पीते पीते उसे उसी जगह पर नींद आ गई. एंड ही स्पेंट द नाइट अमंग दोज स्ट्रेंज फेलो इन दैट स्ट्रेंज empty space. And then what happened? When he woke up next morning, his entire life changed within a night. अगले दिन जब वो उठता है तो उसके लिए पूरी की पूरी जो दुनिया है वो बदल जाती है. Let's see what happens when he wakes up the next morning. On waking, he found himself on the green knoll where he had first seen the old man of the glen. Knoll word is given to you. I am once again writing the meaning of this word so that you can revise it more and more time. नॉल मीन्स स्मॉल हिल या रॉक भी कह सकते हैं आप इसको, ठीक है. एंड ग्लेन मीन्स वैली. सो नेक्स्ट डे व्हेन ही गॉट अप ही वॉज नॉट इन दैट हॉलो स्पेस विद अदर स्ट्रेंज पीपल. अगले दिन जब वो उठा तो वो उन लोग वहाँ पे कोई नहीं था. देयर वर नो बडी हुम ही हैड सीन लास्ट नाइट हु वर प्लेइंग नाइन पिन एंड हु वर ड्रेस्ड इन क्वेंट आउटलैंडिश फैशन. दोज पीपल वर नॉट देयर. इट वॉज नॉट दैट होलो स्पेस. इट वॉज नॉट दैट एम्प्टी स्पेस. इन फैक्ट ही वॉज ऑन दैट रॉक वेयर ही हैड फर्स्ट सीन द ओल्ड मैन ऑफ द वैली. वो फिर उसी जगह पहुँच गया सुबह. जब वो उठता है तो वो देखता है कि मैं तो उसी जगह पर सोया हुआ हूँ जहाँ कल मुझे वो बूढ़ा आदमी मिला था. एंड ही रब्ड हिज आइज. ही हैड स्लेप्ट सो बैडली दैट नाउ ही वॉज रबिंग हिज आइज टू सी एवरी थिंग प्रॉपरली. It was a bright sunny morning. The birds were happily twittering among the bushes. It was a one fine day, sunny day. All the birds were chirping around him. Surely, thought Rip, I have not slept here all night. He recalled the occurrences before he fell asleep. As he rose to walk, he found himself stiff in the joints, wanting in his usual active manner. He got down into the glen with difficulty and found the gully up which he and his companion had ascended the previous evening. Due to his astonishment, a mountain stream was flowing down it. So when he saw that this is not the place where I slept at night, ये वो जगह नहीं है जहाँ मैं कल रात गया था, जहाँ मैंने ड्रिंक पिया था, जहाँ कल रात मैं सोया था, ये वो जगह नहीं है. Surely I have not slept here all night. ऐसा उसने सोचा. ही रिकॉल्ड द अकरेंसेज. प्लीज अंडरलाइन दिस सेंटेंस. रिकॉल द अकरेंसेज मीन्स ही ट्राई टू रिमेंबर व्हाट हैपेंड, राइट. रिमेंबर्ड REMEMBERED रिमेंबर्ड व्हाट हैपेंड बिफोर ही फेल अस्लीप. कल रात क्या हुआ था सोने से पहले, ये उसने याद करने की कोशिश की. उसने याद किया कि कल रात मैं कुछ अजीब लोगों से मिला था, मैंने एक ड्रिंक पिया था, एक बूढ़े आदमी की हेल्प करते करते मैं यहाँ पहुँचा था. एंड आई ड्रैंक अ स्पेशल काइंड ऑफ ड्रिंक एंड आफ्टर दैट आई फेल अस्लीप. What happened after that? How did I reach here? मैं यहाँ कैसे पहुँचा, यहाँ तक मुझे कौन लेके आया. As he rose to walk, now he got up to walk and to see what had happened. He found himself stiff in the joints. He found out that his body was stiff. Stiff means जब आप एक जगह पर बैठे रहते हो आपकी पूरी बॉडी के joints अकड़ जाते हैं. आप खुल के अपनी legs से चल नहीं पाते. आप खुल के अपने arms को हिला नहीं पाते. Your body suddenly becomes very stiff. So he found out that the joints of his body have become very stiff. And wanting in his usual active manner, and he was trying to walk like a normal person. And then what happened? He got up down into the glen with difficulty and found the gully up which he and his companion had ascended. He got down into the glen. वो वैली की तरफ मुड़ता है जहाँ वो बूढ़ा आदमी उसे लेकर गया था. और उसने देखा, he saw, he found the gully up. Gully means narrow path, तंग गली. उसने उस वहाँ उसी रास्ते, जो रास्ते से वो बूढ़े आदमी के साथ चल के गया था, उसने देखा. ही फाउंड दैट गली अप इन विच ही एंड हिज कंपेनियन हैड असेंडेड द प्रीवियस नाइट. बट टू हिज अस्टॉनिशमेंट अ माउंटेन स्ट्रीम वॉज फ्लोइंग डाउन इट. देयर वॉज नॉट दैट नैरो पाथ. जिस रास्ते से होकर वो बूढ़े आदमी के साथ गया था वो रास्ता वहाँ था ही नहीं. इट हैड गॉट डिसअपियर्ड. दैट गली, दैट नैरो पाथ विच ही हैड which he had ascended, which he had walked across with his companion, that old man, that path was not there. It had disappeared. But to his astonishment, astonishment means surprise. Please underline the meaning of gully. Gully means narrow path, NARROWPATH, path. And astonishment means surprise. He saw there was not that narrow path, but what was there in place of that narrow path? There was a mountain stream. Please underline the meaning of stream if you don't know the meaning. Stream means river, R-I-V-E-R. So he saw कि वो रास्ता तो है ही नहीं जिस रास्ते से वो बूढ़े आदमी के साथ गया, वहाँ पे एक नदी बह रही है जो कल शाम तक वहाँ नहीं थी. And this made him really astonished. He was surprised. How is it possible? Within a night, how can everything change? The previous night I had walked across the path with the old man, and now that path has diminished. Now that path had disappeared. Now I can see a river in place of that path. How is it possible? His dog too was nowhere to be seen, and strangely enough, his beard had grown a foot long. His pet dog Wolf was not with him. Within a night, his beard had grown 1 foot long. उसकी दाढ़ी भी एक रात में इतनी लंबी बढ़ गई, जैसे पता नहीं कितने सालों से उसने अपनी दाढ़ी काटी ही नहीं है, शेव ही नहीं की है. And he was highly surprised. How is it possible? I'm feeling as if I have grown old. मुझे ऐसा लग रहा है कि मैं बूढ़ा हो गया हूँ. और मेरे साथ जो मेरा डॉग कल आया था वो भी नहीं है. जो रास्ता मैंने क्रॉस किया वो रास्ता भी मुझे दिखाई नहीं दे रहा. What had happened to me within a night? Rip entered the outskirts of his village, which was strangely altered. It was larger and more populous. His familiar haunts had disappeared. So what happened? Now he left that place, he left that valley where he had gone with the old man the previous night, and he reached the outskirts. Outskirts means boundary, boundary. He reached the boundary of his village, means he entered his village. And what did he see? Even his village had strangely altered.